White Christmas was aired on December 16, 2014 as an hour-long Christmas special, but it was anything but jolly. The society that the main character Matt Trent lives in mirrors real life, except for the fact that everyone lives with implants that can control what they see around them. Matt himself works as a cookie trainer, training a copied digital consciousness enslaved to work for the person they were copied from. The way he easily makes a cookie he's training live 6 months in the span of a few seconds just to break them in shows just exactly how little empathy he has for others. This turns into him becoming the ringleader of a bunch of perverted men who use their implants to watch each other get with women. Eventually, Matt uses his charms to extract a confession from the murderer Joe Potter for a reduced sentence of his criminal activities. During that confession, he uses the blasé term,
"It wasn't really real, so it wasn't really barbaric,"
about his misdeeds with the cookie. Matt's last scene in the episode shows how that progressive technology he abused is now turned around on him, and through perfect visual and auditory storytelling, shows exactly what happens to someone who ignores ethics for the sake of self-gain. Matt's final scene begins with him in a dull gray room just after his successful attempt at extracting the confession from Joe's cookie. This sets the scene for what is going to be the rest of Matt's life. The lighting is natural and yet brings no warmth and brightness to the scene itself. Instead, it enhances the drab colors of the gray walls, the sterile-looking desks, as well as the dark colors the investigators and Matt are wearing. Matt is shot from a high angle, emphasizing his smallness in comparison to the regular medium close-ups of the investigators. Looking at Matt from above paints him as the accused. One investigator is taken from a slight low angle to emphasize her authority as she tells Matt his final sentence.
"It means you're blocked."
"By who?"
"By everyone."
Matt leaves the office in a medium close-up shot, following him as he walks through a dark tunnel until he's lit up by the outside world. It's a rebirth into a new world for Matt, although not a good one. It's here when Silent Night starts to play, the perfect song for the discovery that Matt is about to uncover shortly. I love the way Matt is captured in shot 9, where most of the screen is black except for Matt's face. He's wearing a black coat, and is absorbed by the darkness of the tunnel behind him as he peers around the square he's walked into. I liken this to him being dressed for his own funeral. Not a funeral of death, but of social death. What awaits Matt outside the tunnel is a mass of gray people walking around Christmas displays, shopping together, laughing together, selling their wares, and living a regular life. These people are blocked from Matt, as the investigator had revealed shortly before this. Blocking in this universe is where the blocked, such as Matt, can no longer see, hear, or talk to someone. Due to his crimes, Matt will never be able to see or hear from anyone ever again. The cinematography of this scene is brilliant, as we see from a point of view shot from Matt's perspective as he looks at all the people he can't see anymore. Distorted music plays in the background, and the edges of the frame are dotted and artificial, as if we're seeing from the eyes of someone with a technological implant. Matt's now at the mercy of the technology he used to hurt others. The scene switches between these point of view shots with regular medium shots, as the audience see Matt from an omniscient POV as he runs into a woman. The over-the-shoulder shot shows this woman look up at Matt, her face contorted with nervousness. Then we swap to her point of view, where we see Matt as a bright red silhouette. Although this episode doesn't delve into what the color of a blocked person means, red is an obvious cultural indicator of danger. The woman hurries away, and Matt continues his journey through the square. From afar, a man bends to grab a snow globe and stares at him. What I found interesting about this part was the massive face of Santa Claus behind him. Santa Claus is known for being an all-watchful entity who knows if you've been bad or good. I find it amusing in a sad way that now Matt will always be watched by others. The low-angle shot puts this man at an advantage over Matt, and the aggressive way he stands and stares, mouth forming a smirk, shows that Matt is in danger. Since he is branded in red, he has a literal target on his back for people who hate criminals. Besides the structure of the scene itself, I want to talk about the symbolism behind certain artistic choices for this scene. Silent Night plays in the background while Matt deals with his new reality. It clearly spells out for Matt that the rest of his life will be silent. The Christmas decorations as well create an irony. Matt has just been sentenced to social isolation on the happiest day of the year. Christmas is supposed to be celebrated with loved ones, but unfortunately for Matt, his unempathetic, criminal actions have condemned him to never experience joy on that day ever again. The very last shot we see of Matt is an arc shot. He turns around staring at the blocked, but for the viewer, we see normal people milling about in winter clothing. The only emotions on his face are dread and fear. It looks as if he's on the verge of tears. Matt played the system that he enjoyed using for self-gain, and in doing so, doomed him to be an isolated social pariah. Alone and without companionship, much like the cookies he enslaved. This scene, through clever lighting, angled shots, and the use of symbolic imagery and sound, showed the ironic downfall of a man whose hubris made him fervently believe that he was untouchable from his selfish criminal actions. Now he will be untouchable, and unseeable, and unheard, until the world forgets who he is.